What's up, guys? Frank here with the dudes in O Brother, or the brothers of O Brother.
That's right.
Guilty.
First of all, I have to apologize that it's taken this long to do this interview. Truly one of my top five favorite bands in the world since Garden Window came out, your debut.
Hey, thanks, man.
You're not exactly the most metal band, which is why I didn't, you know, but also I don't necessarily care anymore what the viewers
We don't
think.
Either, man. Like, yes. People try to put us in a certain genre, and we're just like, go ahead. Good luck. Yeah. See where you can throw us.
Yeah. Also, I really feel that those lines have been blurred. Artists like Chelsea Wolfe and everything kind of like just more widely explored in this realm.
Right.
Do you guys see that or do you feel those effects at all?
I think it's not a band goal, but kind of my own personal goal is to try to get people that don't listen to like heavy music to start, and dudes that or people that only listen to like metal and heavy music to branch out a little bit.
Yeah, we kind of want to bridge a little bit of like different genres, kind of putting it all together in one thing.
You know, on that note, it's kind of funny is I have a phrase that I usually say when somebody asks me for a recommendation. You're always at the top of my list, of course. But they're
thanks,
like,
man.
Well, what do they sound like though? And I'm like, well, if Cliff Burton were still alive and joined Radiohead, they'd still be trying to rip off O Brother.
We'll take it. We'll take that.
That's badass.
What I'm really trying to get at here is that you guys transcend genres, you know? That it's more about a feeling, an emotion that you guys strike with people. Like you find these notes and a way of really connecting with people. Do you look for a poised action or depression or anything like this to find the sound of O Brother, or is it simply just picking up your instruments and playing?
Music's always kind of been like a way for all of us to decompress from all this stuff that happens outside of our band. So when we get together to create music, it's like a way for us to like, I don't know, let go some of all the chaos that happens, and it's a way for us to like breathe a little bit.
But
something.
With you saying that, it sounds like we're like super bummed out, kind of depressed dudes.
And we're totally not depressed.
I don't think none of us like really are. We're pretty like stoked on life for the most part. But I do think like unintentionally we do find a certain tone for our sound, and it's kind of an unspoken thing, but we kind of just have a natural agreement on like how a certain song or a certain album is tone-wise, like what it's gonna sound like. But like I said, it is kind of unintentional. It just comes naturally that, you know, a lot of our songs just kind of sound like a big bummer, but but we're cool, but we promise.
and of course, I wasn't trying to make like a negative thing out of that.
No.
I love emotional music, and
yeah,
you know,
we do too.
But beyond that emotional value, I think when one area your band really excels at is not only finding the notes that strike a nerve with people, but really finding the space between those notes. You know, do you? As a band with three guitar players, bass, drums, piano, and so many moving elements, do you have to work at trying to scale back songs or scale back parts so you're not overplaying?
Sure, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, I think we try to utilize emptiness and space a lot on our last record, Endless Light, and that's something that we never really tried before. Like, we're always like, full assault, like, you know, everyone playing the same thing, blah blah blah. But Endless Light, we were kind of utilizing more empty space, and I might even say this newer one that we just got done recording is
even more so.
Yeah, like more on the same lines. Yeah. Maybe even a little bit more extreme than the last one, but yeah, I think that emptiness kind of makes the bigger parts a little more purposeful
and more effective. Yeah. There's several songs where I honestly didn't even pick up an instrument. Like, I'm being dead serious. Like, it's awesome. Like, over the years of touring and making records, it's like, it's changed the way how we think about how effective or necessary an instrument needs to be, you know? Like, if there's three guitars, like, not all three needs to
someone,
be.
Someone can chill for a
yeah,
second.
Yeah, it's fine. But, you know, like, back in the day when we first started, like,
we were
had
still
three
learning,
guitars,
yeah.
we were just, like, wall of sound.
Right.
And that's effective, right? But, you know, the more and more we played, it was like, maybe if we did two guitars of the same part, that would fill out the space and one other person could do something else or not do anything at all. And just has a completely different sound than, like, everyone playing chords at the same time, you know?
Another aspect I notice is how DIY you guys really are, you know, like, always at the merch table or, you know, Michael being, tour managing.
We would be
and
dead without Michael. Like, yeah. Seriously, we would be lost or late. Definitely broke all the time, but
and
Michael...
He does merch as well.
Yeah.
But, yeah, Michael keeps us all...
Well, I know, you know, the DIY scene is kind of a big thing in Georgia, the scene out there and everything. I just want to know, is the DIY aspect of the culture ingrained in O Brother? Is that still part of what you do?
We want to have a little bit of control of our art and what we do as, like, not just the business, but, like, our passion.
Yeah, we try to do everything as much as we can ourselves. Yeah. Like, a lot of our artwork, merch design stuff, like, we either come up with it or we find an artist that we love and respect and, like, try to do a collaboration. But, like, a lot of our records, artwork, and, like, layout and stuff, Michael and Johnny has, like, collaborated on doing it all.
Yeah, it's all
a lot of our merch designs is, like, photos that Johnny has taken or something Michael has designed. And it's just, you know, another outlet for our artistic expression, I guess you could say.
Yeah. And less variables, honestly. Like, if we have someone else do it, like, it's just gonna take a little bit more time, more money, and all this stuff. When we can honestly just do it ourselves, a lot of the times. I mean, some things you can't really, you know, deter from, or, like, we will need someone to do certain things,
right.
But, like...
But we try to save money as much as we can, so we, like, you know... We're sewing patches on tour for our beanies and stuff instead of getting someone else to do it.
Yeah. Poking ourselves with thumbs like during the band.
Just a lot of things that we
can.
Exactly. It feels like it sometimes. We're just like, oh my God, I'm gonna get it done. we just try to do everything ourselves as much as we can. Just because it's something that we've always done and just feels normal and natural to us. So.
I'm glad that you guys are here because I have this theory that brothers. And bands have this really weird connection, this unspoken connection that really works, and you kind of lock in somehow. I mean, it's always work, you know, like Pantera, Sepultura, all the great bands have that. Do you guys feel that amongst yourselves?
Well, we don't know anything else because
we've always played together,
music
together. We learned music together. Michael, our drummer, is our brother-in-law and also... picked up the drums the same day we picked up our bass and guitar,
we
learned how to play music together, and it's just kind of always been that way. And but yeah, there is a connection,
I would say.
Most times, like when we're on stage or when we're like writing together and stuff like that.
I'm glad that you brought up the new album. I actually wrote back in April that you guys were in the studio. I wanted to know if there's any kind of release date or plans set in motion yet.
No release date as of yet, but our general goal is to have it out by early 2020. So that's kind of right around the corner, but there's a couple of things we need to do before we do release it.
Yeah. So a couple patches.
Like name it. We haven't named it yet. Yeah. It's done, recorded, and everything, but we got to name it and, get a few things together. And then, but, yeah, we're hoping for something maybe before summer next year.
Yeah.
And what could fans expect from it? I mean, I know that you guys kind of always have this new sonic, envelope going on with every one of them. Is this a departure or is it?
It's still an O Brother record.
Yeah.
But with that, I always say to people, like, O Brother will never write the same record twice. So I don't know how much that gives away. But yeah, I mean, we've incorporated a lot of things that we haven't before. So sonically it's different, but I think the tone is still it's an O Brother record.
There's different elements, like he was saying, that we've never done before. It sounds like us, however it's definitely like something completely
different
that we've done in the past. It's definitely the prettiest record we've ever done, I think.
Wow.
That's all I'll say.
That sounds promising. I can't wait to hear it. I don't know about you. Of course, check it out when it's out. We'll keep up with these guys and check them out on tour. They're out right now.